Hi guys, Squirrel here. Well, summer's definitely in the air in the UK. It's been pretty warm of late, 35, 40 degrees in some places. I thought, what better place to go than one of my favourite areas down towards Somerset, Devon and Cornwall, and because in Flight Simulator, I've actually flown around the north of Somerset and Devon. So this one here, this West Somerset Railway, actually takes us, this scenario here takes us to Minehead. And I flew past Minehead in the Flight Simulator series, so I thought this would be quite cool. So we've got a Class 47 diesel electric. We're on a diesel heritage day. It says, departing from crowded Willerton Station, drive the Class 47 hauling a rake of Mark 1 coaches to Minehead and back, forming one of two shuttle trains operating a diesel's day on the West Somerset Railway. During operations, a Class 03 will be performing demonstration freight at the yard in Willerton. That sounds quite fun. It sounds to be a great day. It's summer, it's clear, it's in the afternoon. It should be lovely scenery. I really like the look of this Class 47, so let's give this a whirl. Oh, wow. Look at this. This is beautiful. It's a gorgeous train. Let's open the doors. Willerton. Right, let's have a look inside. Let's get track IR sorted out here. Yeah, that seems to be actually quite good. When did we have to leave? Pick up passenger 1545. Okay, departing in 1545. Let's have a look around. I think this is the train brake, the loco brake, the horn maybe? That's the horn. AWS, reset, wipers, buttons. That one, no, they don't work. Power handle, reverse, we'll stick that forward now. We've got over here cab lights, don't need that. Headlights. What is that on now? Daylight running, I think. I think that's daylight running. I think that'll do. Nothing else works. Nothing over there works, I don't think. Okay, let's have a quick look around here. D1661IV53. Oh, it's such a lovely train. I love trains like this. What's the inside the cab? Oh, this is straight out of Harry Potter and Sherlock Holmes. Look at this. Oh, this is how things used to be. I do miss this. Six people in glorious comfort in their own little place. Oh, man, that's so nice. Robertson's Golden Shred Marmalade. Look at that. That is an old sign. This is fantastic. Oh, there's another train. There's another train coming in. It's got a single daylight, so I think it looks like I had the daylight setting right. Doesn't seem to be as detailed as this one. But it's got lots of passengers on it. What are you looking at your watch for, pal? The train's here. Time to depart. See you later, bro. Let's jump back in. Let's go. Reverser, brakes off. Looks like we've got a notched acceleration thing. You can see it here. One. Two. So, does it work? Yeah, you can't put it halfway, look. You can't do that. Which is a bit weird. Okay, just have to live with it. Bye-bye, Willerton! Watch the speed, Paul. Watch the speed. Oh, is this the demonstration thingy they're on about? Let me speed up here. I think this is the freight demo that we're talking. Remember in the scenario? This kind of looks like it, doesn't it? Oh, that's so cool! That is so cool! Uh-oh, I'm brake, I'm speeding! No, 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 no! Oh, see, looking at external camera loses your points. There was a guy on Twitter actually tweeted me and said, "Can you, Squirrel, can you please stay inside the cab for the whole journey?" Like, no, I don't want to do that. I want to have a look around. I like the scenery. I want to see the scenery and the train. And he's like, "Well, you could just do a quick drive if you want to see the scenery." I'm like, well, sorry, bro, but that's not how I play these games. Yeah, I can understand him wanting to do that. I can understand, you know, the more kind of hardcore train driver would want to sit in the cab and just, you know, be like a train driver. He can't get out of the cab. Why should you? And I get that. I get that. But But I don't play games like that. I kind of want to enjoy the train. I want to enjoy the scenery. I like looking at scenery. It's part of the fun for me. And going external camera allows me to do that. And yeah, it leads to errors. It leads to AWS reset errors, speeding errors, as you just saw. I totally accept that. But that's the way I play games. And I kind of play them for fun and entertainment. And that's the way I want to play it. I don't want to sit internal camera for 100%. I don't even do that in the flight sims. The flight sims, I'm always going external. And that's just the same principle. Hang on, this is a weird platform. Why is this 15 miles per hour here? Come on, brakes. Come on, come on, come on. We need a bit more, need a bit more. Okay. What on earth is this? Doniford Halt. How do you even get to that platform? How did that woman get there? She just jumped down over the fence. Look at this. There is no connection to that road. Oh, I'm speeding again. How did she get on that platform? But it's got flowers on it and everything. That's so weird. That thing had a 15 miles per hour limit. Oh, look at the sea. Oh, that's beautiful, isn't it? GTA 5 can hold nothing to the sea here. It is like mirror-like. Somerset Mirror Sea, is that? That's what we're looking at here. You know, it's not GTA 5, is it? Let's have a look out the right-hand window. That's a good view. The track IR works here. You can just move your head around like that, which is kind of cool. I do like that they put track IR in this game. I really do. It's a wonderful addition. You can't imagine how nice it is being able to just freely do this. If you've never tried track IR. Oh. I mean, there are cheaper alternatives to track IR, but it seems to have the most support in games. The thing that clips to the side of your head is a little bit flimsy, but you got to look after it, that's for sure. And it's not cheap, but you only make the one purchase, and then it works in loads of games. It works in your flight simulators, your train simulators, your driving simulators. It's one of those things that when you get round to it, once you've got like your base equipment done, and you've got some good performance out of your equipment, once you've got that nailed, and then maybe you move up to a, I don't know, steering wheel, or flight yoke, that kind of thing, the next thing you should be looking for is something like a track IR. Just to give you that extra immersion, you know? Watch it, we're coming to watch it. I saw a whistle sound on the floor there, so I whistled. Okay, what speed are we doing? 23, that's good. Oh, hang on, no, there's a 15 limit coming. Wait a sec. Uh-oh. Oh, I don't want to get done for speeding as we cross this. I just made it, look at that. Right. Let's say hi, let's try and scare them a little bit. Good morning! Actually, it's good afternoon. Imagine doing that. The troll train driver. Hello, are you from Watch It? Do you live here or are you just a tourist? Not very chatty, are you? Never mind. What's this? Drink fizzy refreshments. Motor oil, household luxury curtains, Western Supermer. Fantastic. Welcome to Watch It, booking office. This is really nice scenery, I like this. Okay, we're on time, that's good news. Let's open the door. Everybody get in. What's this here? Museum open. Let's have a look. Watch It Boat Museum, apparently. Nice. It's funny that there's a boat museum. It's actually quite far from the water here. This actually would have been better down there, actually somewhere near the water. But who knows if it's modelled exactly. One last thing on the track IR front, and then I'll shut up about that. Video description does contain quite a healthy discount on track IR if you're looking to get one. So yeah, bear that in mind. You may be able to get it cheaper anywhere, somewhere else. That's fine if you can. I'm just saying, if you want to get one, there is a discount. And I don't get anything out of that. Trust me on this. I get zero out of that. It's not. I'm not saying it. You're probably thinking, oh yeah, sell out squirrel. No, I get nothing for that. That is just for your benefit. I said to them, look, I use track IR quite a bit. A lot of my viewers, you know, want track IR. Can we get them a discount? and they give me a discount, and I don't take any commission for it at all. So don't be thinking I'm selling out or something. That's just for your benefit. But by all means, if you can get it cheaper anywhere else, please do. I just thought I'd bring it up. Oh, I love this town. It's beautiful. Look at it. It's a gorgeous little town. All right, 20 miles per hour limit. We are on a slight incline up, I think. I wonder if this thing is single track all the way. I like what they've done with the trees, by the way. Can you see this? On some of the older scenarios, the trees are just a 2D picture of a tree, if you like. And then as you kind of go past it, it always faces you, always rotates around to look at you. So the tree looks the same, no matter which way you look at it. But if you look at these trees, they're actually a bunch of 2D slices of leaves modeled around a 3D shape, if you get what I mean. So as you do that, can you see that now? You can kind of move around it. It's a lot more depth to it. It's not a perfect thing, but trees are actually quite hard to model accurately without them taking loads, because there are so many trees around as well. That's the other thing. If you model a tree really, really accurately and then you put hundreds of them down, it will kill your FPS. So all of these things are an approximation, and they look pretty good. You know, they're a good compromise. The performance is good, but they, you know, they look tree-like, they look 3D. What was that on my left over there? Look. So it's some kind of industrial area. I can see lots of planks, I think. I can't really get a good view at the moment because of all the trees. But I think it's a factory. Maybe a sawmill or a furniture factory or something. Okay, we are cruising at 20. It's all looking good. And this is one straight track. Look at that. Actually, it's not. It's more of an S-bend, isn't it? But it is all single track. It's a bit hard to keep the speed limit going here because we're going up a slight incline and I'm on idle, but if I go to one notch of speed, you'll see the speedometer now. My speed quickly starts to rise towards 20 and I have to straight away throttle back again. So it's like dancing between first gear and neutral. I have no fine grain control. But I guess that's what you have to do if you drive this train. The brakes have got more fine grain control. You can, you know, it goes everything from 0 to 100% and everything between. So if we was going downhill, uh-oh, forgot level crossing. If we was going downhill, I'd be able to control the descent a lot better than I can control the ascent. What is this? A dirt track into a field. That's a bit of a weird one. Unless this is where they keep, like, why are there no sheep here and stuff? There should be livestock kicking around. I could kind of get that if that was a sheep thing and they bring all the sheep in there and then shear them and whatever. That would make a lot of sense. Now this is a straight track and I'm doing 11 for some reason. I've now slowed down to 11 because I'm not paying any attention. Let's get the speed up. I tell you what, if you was a train driver on this route, right, this is really relaxing. Because you're on a single track, so you've got exclusive token access to be on this track, right? Another whistle sign there, look, see it? Just there. Assume there's another level crossing. And all you've got is the sound of your engine just idling behind you. And the gentle k-k-k-k over the track. Which is, of course, the wheels passing over the gaps in the track. Uh-oh. 6 points lost. And that's it. It's just that, and then the sound of the countryside, because there's just nothing around here. There are no roads, there are no cars, there's no noise. It's just beautiful countryside, a lovely summer's day. You and your train. You can almost have nobody in the back. Very nice. I can only assume the limit of 20 is down here for one of two reasons. Either because we're crossing over level crossings and it's a safety thing, or because they're trying to preserve this old track, or because it's a hot day. Could be any of those things. I think it might be a safety thing. But you may know better. If you do, leave a comment, let me know. Okay, we are climbing up to Washford, apparently. What time do we have to be in Washford? 16:01. We are 5 seconds early as our ETA, so we're good. Oh, come on, game. Stop penalising me just for going, like, 0.1 mile an hour over the limit. Just dancing on that accelerator. That's the only downside of this particular vehicle. I do wonder if this kind of thing, does it wear the clutch out? Because you're effectively going between neutral and you know, you're engaging and disengaging power all the time. Surely this wears a clutch down. Can't be good for the train. I'm assuming we need another whistle here. I could be wrong. Over the bridge! I wonder if we've got any passengers to pick up. This thing's got a... Look at this. It's got these houses here. We've got a siding here. With some of these carriages, I think, and then some freight stuff lying around. I think we'll just freewheel into here and then brake as we get halfway down the platform. Should do it. Oh, look at that lamp! That, like, old bulb. Probably used to be a gas lamp many years ago. Let's get some brakes. Good afternoon! Hello, friendly train driver here, wondering why half of your platform is covered in grass. That's a bit weird. Is that a modelling error? I think that might be a modelling error. Hey bros, how's it going? How's it hanging, man? Do you want to get on the train? Do you want to leave Washford? Do you want to go to Minehead? It's exciting in Minehead. They're just so posing, those two. They are so posing. Do you know what I mean? Oh, vehicles! Look at that. Exciting times. Washford. I need to have a look at the sign in a second. There's a sign over here. Home of the Somerset and Dorset Railway Trust Museum and Workshops. Fantastic. Okay. Brake release. Look at the thing, look at the speed this thing just picks up. It's amazing. Still single track down here. Throttle down a bit. Next stop is Blue Anchor Down Platform 1609. Speeding. 15 points lost, 17 points lost. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. It's so easy to lose that gold medal. It really is. Yeah, I'm not bothered. I'm here to enjoy. It's like in those games, you know, the there are people... Hang on, we're going downhill here. There are people who complete the, like, 100% of a game. And I've never, ever been bothered to do that. Like, 100% of a game. And some of the things they'll have you doing. Like, on the Batman games, for example, some of the things that you have to do to get 100% are just... Oh, my life. Like, you can't just do it all in single player either. Assassin's Creed, I remember on the PS4, and my mate was doing Batman on PS4, I remember that. He had to go and play, do stuff in multiplayer online. Just pointless, tedious stuff. Never mind, like, you know, in Assassin's Creed, going finding all 100 vantage points and finding all secret 250 pigeons. He's like, what are you doing with your life? Just to get what? To get a platinum trophy? Well, GG, bro. I don't know. I don't get it. You're either the kind of person who gets that, or you're with me. You're thinking, why would anybody do that? Each to his own. If you want to get your money's worth out of the game, I suppose. Oh, lovely countryside. It's beautiful. And this is the straightest piece of track ever invented by man. Let's get some speed going. Uh-oh. Just went over. Oh, my brakes won't come on. Look at all the points I'm losing because I braked and then released. That's the worst thing you can do because you can't get the brake pressure back quickly. So I just lost a metric ton of points right there. So yeah, I forgot this was going downhill and I've got to judge the braking amount. 17% seems to be working quite well, though. I just got to keep my eye on it. But it is easier to control this descent. I knew it would be. What does that say on the side here? British Railways. Nice. Just look at the detail on this. It's pretty nice. I mean, all the texture of the wheels spinning around. I'm guessing you would see the suspension articulate. Brush traction. Look at this on the side here. Let's release some of the brakes a touch. Actually, no, we won't. We will not do that because we need to get down to 15 in a second. I'll keep the brake pressure on. Although I don't think I can. Yes, I can. That's good. If I release it down to 6%, I can pick up my speed again. That's fine. We are still descending. Into blue anchor down platform. So relaxing, isn't it, eh? So chill. You could sit in the back, though, with a beer or a cocktail or something, or just a good book or a newspaper and just relax. Signal. I wonder I've not seen any level crossings. Need to keep my eye out for those whistle signs. Looking at the cloud there, the high level cloud is moving very quickly compared to the low. That's kind of weird and wrong, I think. Oh well. It's not Cloud Simulator. Right, let's get some braking on. Let's get down towards 15. What does this station look like, I wonder? There we go. Don't release the brakes, don't release the brakes. So let's release the brakes. We are on the flat surface now, I can release the brakes, it's fine. 15, there it is. Yes, he crosses the line at 14.5. Ooh, two tracks. This is interesting. We've actually got two platforms here, look. So this is a... actually, it'd be interesting to see if it merges again in a second. Whistle. Do you see the sign down there? Whistle. Yeah, this is the first time I've seen the two-track, two-platform layout, so... Either it's going to continue like this, or it's going to merge back into a single, in which case this is a passing point. The Blue Anchor! Sounds like a pub. All right, look ahead, it merges. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, ladies. Let me just get the brakes on. Oh, whoa, whoa, get the brakes on quick. Get the brakes on quick. This is... Wow, this is a nice area. I need to have a look around here. Dude, am I here on time? Stop looking at your watch, okay? Get your doors open. We are good. Let's have a look around. Blue anchor, what have you got? Look, this was the lamp I was talking about before. I reckon they used to be gas lamps in olden days. Plenty of people here. Wow, these guys live. Look at this. This is a two-track platform. There's a train coming. Which is right by the sea. And I think I saw... Did I see a caravan park over there? I did. Look, there's a caravan park here. You see plenty of those in North Somerset. If you watch the Flight Sim series, you know exactly what I mean. They're just every 500 metres. All along the coast. Until they can't. Basically, where they don't build them is where you've got cliffs like that. But anywhere where it's right next to the sea, there's just caravan like this. All down here. That's a steam train. Oh, my life. That is so cool. Do I have to leave yet? I can't leave yet. I'm on a red signal. What time were you to leave? 16:18. Really? Oh, no. Hang on. Leave 16:10. I can't leave. Oh, this is, sounds so brilliant. Oh, I love that sound. That is nice. Yeah, so I'm guessing he's stopping there. This is a, like I say, it's a passing point. Okay, green signal. We can go. That's sweet. The fact that you saw that move as well, that's really good. But yeah, I don't understand. We should have left at 16:10, but there's no way we could leave at 16:10. Wow, the textures on that are very good. Nice. So now he goes back to where I just came from, and I go to where he came from. So I guess when you travel on this line, maybe you've got to... Why this... Why are we speeding so badly? What's going on? We're not going downhill. Why do I need so much brake? Genuinely doesn't feel like I'm going downhill, but I am, because when I take the brake off, I'm actually accelerating. That is a big beach. My only criticism is why this line is such a slow speed. I'm guessing... My guess now, my latest guess, is because it is a heritage line. Therefore, people who go on it are not actually, in quotes, travelling, commuting. They just basically want to see the scenery. So the trains... go slowly so that people can just look at the scenery. Because if this thing flies down here at 50, people probably complain and say, I don't get to see anything. Why don't you go a bit slower and we can enjoy it? That would make a lot of sense. So I'm going to stick into that story now. I think that may be the reason. Next stop. Dunster. 1.25 miles. Pickup 16:17. ETA 16:17. Okay, we're actually on time. That's fine. We're on time. I was a bit worried there that the departure time for that last station was incorrect. And it set an impossible target, but that's not the case. That was a nice station, actually. It had some interesting features. You know, kind of branching away from the coast now. So yeah, I've not looked on the map, but I'm fairly sure at this point we're inside the Exmoor National Park. It would make a lot of sense. But without checking, I don't know. Dunster coming up. Seems to be a common thing, 25 mile an hour track speed, then 15 at the stations. There was just that weird station that wasn't actually on the layout down the bottom here. The one that we drove past that had no connection. That was acting like a proper station because it had a 15 miles an hour limit on it. Let's get close to the 25. I'm sure when I was a kid and I had train sets and stuff, I'm sure I had a train just like this. I'm almost certain I did. I definitely had a Flying Scotsman. I'd love to know. It's one of those great mysteries of life. Is what happened to all of my train set equipment, you know? What happened to all of my Scale X-Tray? What happened to all of my Lego? What happened to all of my Meccano? Did I just at some point get bored of it? Or did my mum throw it away and just never tell me? Or did she actually say to me, let's throw this away, and I agreed to it? I just can't remember. I just know that when I'm older, I think, what happened to that stuff? It's weird. I'm sure I'm not the only one. If your life was on a big giant video recorder, and you could just wind back and watch different things again, I'd like to go back and just try and work out what happened though. Okay, I can see a whistle sign here. Look, level crossing. Okay, let's get a bit more brakes. Get the speed down to 15. There we go. Sidle it. Actually, I'm saying idle it, but the speed's picking up again. Ooh, cars and stuff. Look at that. Not seen too many of those on the track. Plenty of time. We're actually slightly early. Not worried about cruising in slowly. Whistle again. Oh look, a grass platform. It wasn't an accident. I guess they genuinely have grass platforms. Good afternoon. Stop looking at your watch, time-obsessed people. Look at it. Just relax, okay? Toilets, waiting room. Look at the... Are you kidding me? Look at that. What happened to fire extinguishers? They've actually got buckets. Wow, this place. It's old school. Nice modelling, though. Apart from that van. We'll just ignore the white van. Everything else is pretty good. Even down to the stuff on the platform. And the dude walking right through it. You gotta love that. That immersion. That immersion. Where's he gone? Look, he just vanished in the building. Stop walking through scenery. You're ruining the immersion. Behave yourself. Could they really not have just pathed it around? Oh, man. Just notice not over the other side here, look. The freight stuff going on. The cars. The cars are being... This is weird. They should be driving right now. So, hang on. This was a... Ah, there's a siding into the shed there. That's fine. Where does that one go? That's just a dead end. So, that must go back there. How he got his van here, only he knows, quite frankly. That looks a bit big. I'm sure they're meant to be a bit smaller than that. So I'm just critiquing the scenery. I like the station, though. The station's quite cool. But yeah, I don't think they should all be waiting here. They should have... the level crossing could have gone down a minute or two ago. Because that's a big queue. I feel sorry for them. I'd be complaining. If I was sat in that car right now, I'd be like, oh, for God's sake, are you kidding me? Why am I waiting here? All aboard! Sorry, love. But, you know, you wiggled around the corner a bit too late, and you've missed the train. But you're probably waiting for the steam train, aren't you? Platform 9 3/4. Yeah, you might wait a while for that. On behalf of Heritage Railways, I'd like to apologise for the delay to your journey this morning, or this afternoon. It was caused by... I don't know. Weird signalling. It's probably the way. Weird signal it was caused by. More points lost for speeding! I'll be lucky if I get a bronze at the end of this. Because those points, they just add up like every set. I've always hated that. I've always hated the way it does. The penalty points for speeding are ridiculous. Like, it penalises you every second. And I'm sorry, but you just can't adjust to that. You know, there are times when you might go over the limit, but you'll go... Why does that say 10? Are you kidding me? 10 if I'm going into the siding, surely. There are times when you can't, avoid the speeding. And it just takes a little bit of adjustment to get it under control. But in that little bit of adjustment, you might lose 7 seconds while you're waiting for the brakes to actually action. And in those 7 seconds, you've lost nearly 100 points. And you just think, that's a bit excessive. So I kind of wish they'd changed that. But yeah. I think there was a level crossing coming up. Ooh. Well, look at that. That's pretty cool. An actual pedestrian crossing point. Although it looks like another one. Didn't see a whistle sign as such. I think it's another pedestrian crossing point. Let's see if I can read that sign as we go past. Oh, I couldn't read that. That happened too quickly. I think the next stop is, we're actually 5 seconds late. Yeah, this like Minehead platform is the terminus. It's been a fun journey. Like I say, I think I'm gonna get smashed on points, but hey, I've quite enjoyed the route. Pretty straightforward one as well. I might try one of the other ones, the freight ones. That could be interesting. Or maybe the steam train. I think the steam train might be a good one to try. Can't beat the sound of a steam train in Somerset. Oh. Alright, that is definitely a whistle point. I can see the sign there. I'm also going to start slowing down. We are coming down to a 10 miles per hour speed limit. Are we going to split onto a second platform, I wonder? How's this going to work? Okay, can we cruise in at 10.5, I wonder? Wow, we've got, look at this. Going over the road here. Look, you can see the beach down there. That's hilarious. Oh, actually, there's quite a lot of platforms. That surprises me. Oh, listen to that! Car park. This is pretty cool. There are no passengers here, bizarrely. Very quiet in Minehead. Oh, there are some. There are some here. What are we, 9.2? Yeah, we're here slightly early. It's good. We're on time. Good afternoon, sir. How are you, Mr. Grumpy? Is that a steam train leaving next to us? Oh, that is too good. Not really sure where it wants us to stop, to be honest. I guess anywhere around here would do. Where's that steam train gone? Oh, look at it. It's just reversing out. Look at the, look at the watches again. Stop it. Nice. Nice, 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 nice. I enjoyed that. That was a beautiful run. Well done, driver. You have successfully completed all the tasks required. The Diesel Gala has been a resounding success. West Somerset Diesel's Resurrection Award or something. Oh, look at that. I was so close to a gold. I got a silver. Oh, look at the points. Minus two, minus two, minus two, minus two, minus two. All of my points, like everything I did was bang on. Like timeliness was bang on. I just lost a lot of points for those little speedings, and that was enough to not give me a gold medal. So that was the... which profile was it? That one. There you go. I got the silver. 894 points for that one. Maybe on the next video, maybe I'll try one of the other ones. Maybe try one of the... Like this one here is a steam. That one there is a bit more difficult. Summer spin. A challenge timetable. Maybe we'll do another one. But that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed that. Don't forget to leave some comments and click like if you did enjoy it. Until the next video, guys, take care and happy training.